5.
Welcome back to the DL Link Show. Nikki Seberini here, and looking forward to spending the next 40 minutes with you, a little bit more than that. We're talking about fertility, or rather infertility, and we're going to be focusing on all areas, and also a cancer warrior will be joining us and sharing her story, her and her husband's story. So I have Dr. Lawrence Gobetz on the line. He's a reproductive medicine specialist, and he's a fellow of the College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. And Dr. Gobetz, welcome. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks, Nikki. Great to be on your show.
So very interesting, Dr. Gobetz. I had no idea that there was such a thing called World Infertility Awareness Month, which is the month of June, which says a lot about infertility around the world. Let's just start off by identifying, and perhaps you can go into a little bit more detail, what in fact is infertility?
So, I mean, it's a definition, and the definition is the inability to have achieved a conception within a year. If the female is under the age of 35, it doesn't reference the age of the male. And if the female's over 35, one says, if you have not achieved a pregnancy in 6 months, go and seek help. So that's defined by the fact that we know that in most cases, if the female's under 35 and the couple have been trying, within 6 months, 86% of patients are pregnant. And then a small percentage drag on for the next 6 months. So by the time you get to a year, we're sitting with about 10% of couples not actually having conceived. And that then becomes the definition.
Okay, so for people who are listening now, and maybe people are trying and they're wondering, the year is really the amount of time you should be looking at before you would go and seek the help of a specialist.
But not again, I qualify and say, not if the female's older than the age of 35. And that's it's a very important thing because, you know, today the most important issue of why there seems to be an upswing is the fact that women are delaying their childbearing. It's not normal. You know, I was born in the 50s, and my mother and all her friends had half-day jobs, and they would sit around the poker table in the lounge playing cards, and every one of them by 22 had 3 kids at home. So you talk to an average 22-year-old and say you must complete your family, you know, they haven't even finished their degrees at university, and then establishing themselves in their careers and then putting some money in the bank, and then eventually when they do find Mr. Right and they do want to settle down because now they've traveled, you know, the average age of the female is 37, 38. And that is something that unfortunately one is having difficulty getting it across because that is modern society. And interestingly, the reason why this all happens is because the ovary is very different to the testicle. An ovary has no stem cells, and a woman is born with a total complement of eggs, and every month she's losing hundreds of thousands of eggs. And that's why a woman ultimately goes into the menopause. So what happens is as the woman ages, so do her eggs age. And those eggs, therefore, do not have the potential to allow normal embryos to form. So as you get older as a female, your potential goes down. And we know that the average age of patients crossing our threshold are in the region of about 37.2 years of age. And I'm talking, again, female age. Us guys, our testicles have got stem cells, and you can put us in a wheelchair and roll us into our grave, and I can tell you those testicles are still making sperm for procreation.
Incredible.
So, you know, and that's where the big difficulty is to try and get through to the younger girls now that fortunately, and as you've said, thank goodness with Facebook and technology, how we can get to your podcast, young girls today can put their eggs in the freezer. And as you said, you've got a warrior coming on, and interestingly, the only girls today that really willingly come off the street to freeze their eggs are those who have unfortunately a diagnosis of cancer at an early age, and we can fortunately put their fertility on hold by putting their eggs in the freezer. And once they've survived their cancer, we can then help them with IVF and their frozen eggs and get them a family.
Wow. Okay. So that's very interesting. So let's focus on females first, because we'll get to males and those who do have problem with what's it called, adenosuspermia or whatever it's called, and we'll get there. But let's focus on females. Let's look at the age, because you've identified the age of 35, and that from 35 and up there could be. It's not to say that there will be, that there could be problems with falling pregnant, and you have suggested this freezing of the egg. So let's go into detail. Let's look at that. You're a young female. It's your career. You haven't yet found a man. You haven't even thought of having children or a family. It's just not in your sphere. What is involved in freezing eggs?
Okay, so every month in an ovary, somewhere between 100 and 1,000 eggs enter a race. Now, in that race, those eggs are unfortunately fortunately genetically programmed to die off when one runs ahead and wins the race, because the womb is only made for one baby. So every month, a woman is losing a large number of eggs. We learned that if we could manufacture the hormone that the brain tells the ovary to grow one egg, we could rescue those eggs that are going to be programmed to die off. So we take this injection and we give it to the patient over a period of 10 or 11 days. And what happens is we then ripen maybe 15 or 20 eggs, which were eggs that that patient would have lost in that cycle anyway. And once we've scanned and we're happy with the size of the sacs that house the eggs, we know those eggs are now ripe or mature. We give a final maturation injection, and 36 hours later, we take the patient into our IVF suite where we have a theater facility. We give the patient conscious sedation and we recover the eggs vaginally. It's a procedure that literally takes about 10 minutes. The patient is almost wide awake afterwards. It's not a full anesthetic. They feel no discomfort and they get a little sticker on their hand with a smiley on, and on that is the number of eggs that we got. So we can then hopefully have somewhere between 15 and 20 eggs out of that cycle. But what's important to understand is that when you work with eggs in a laboratory or embryos in a laboratory, we start off, and I always describe it as a funnel. So here we have this wide funnel where we now have 20 eggs, of which probably 80% of those eggs are going to be ripe. So that says we're now down to 16 eggs. So now we put the 16 eggs in the freezer, and the important thing to appreciate is 16 eggs is not equal 16 babies. So when you warm those eggs, you would expect 98 to 99% of them to survive the warming process, but only 50% to fertilize with the partner's sperm. And of that 50%, the funnel goes even further downwards to a more narrow exit, which leaves us with, of that 50%, we'll have 50% of those then becoming embryos. So if we've gone from 16 eggs down to 8 fertilized, we're now down to 4 embryos. And of those 4 embryos, depending on the age of those eggs, if those eggs are young, 22, 24 years old, 1 in 2 embryos will be genetically competent. But if those eggs are 35, we'll need 1 in 3 or 1 in 4 embryos to be genetically competent. And what happens is, as a woman gets older, her response to the drugs is lower, and they don't give us as many eggs. She may only give us 8 eggs. So if you're thinking in terms of, well, I'm going to put my my insurance policy in place and I'm going to have my eggs in the freezer to at least have 2 babies, if you are 20, you need to have 20 eggs in the freezer to hopefully give you 2 babies. If you're 40, we need 40 eggs in the freezer to give you 2 babies. So, you know, it's not like, and people think that if I've got 40 eggs in the freezer, that means I've got a chance to have 40 babies. It is not the case. And unfortunately, you know, this is not put across correctly to patients. Patients are not counseled. And sometimes they've got 16 eggs in the freezer at 40 and they think, well, they've got their whole family in front of them. They don't have it. You know, they need to be counseled correctly.
Yeah, I mean, that's very important information. So probably what you're looking at is they wouldn't just go in once to have eggs extracted. Maybe you would do it a few times to make sure that you've got a few batches of eggs, and hopefully better success if the funnel dwindles the numbers down that way.
Yeah, Nikki, you're absolutely correct. The only problem is that, you know, we see it, and IVF is not a walk in the park on the one hand, but in today's times, it's actually quite an easy process. And whether it's IVF or stimulating to get eggs out to put in the freezer, they're all one and the same thing. Once you've got the eggs, if you now go and fertilize the eggs with a partner sperm, then it becomes IVF. But to get to the eggs, they have exactly the same process as someone undergoing stimulation for IVF. But yes, if you're 40, you may need, if you only get 6 eggs out of each stimulation, you know, are you going to do this 5 times or 6 times to get close to 40 eggs? No one will do that. Firstly, it's extremely costly if you work it out at 6 times. And secondly, we know the dropout rate's quite high even after one attempt because it's a lot that the patient feels they go through. So those that are psychologically set on the fact that they know they've got to put a number in, they'll do it 2 or 3 times. The younger girls invariably, that's why it's important if you're going to freeze eggs, to freeze them as young as you possibly can. Because if you freeze them at 20 and you use them when you're 40, your success is equal to the age that your success was at the time that you froze the eggs. So if you're now 40 and you take those 20-year-old eggs out the freezer, your chances are the same as if you were 20. Because, you know, in the freezer, there's no shelf life. It's not like Woolworths where we put a use-by date or sell-by date on it. You can leave them in the freezer for as long as you want to. So, yes, if you're older and in order to at least have 2 kids out of it, you've got to do the stimulation a few times to get the prescribed number of eggs to at least give you, because of that funnel, your ultimate number.
Sure. Dr. Gobetz, we're going to take a break. After the break, let's continue with this discussion. It's fascinating. We'll also be highlighting, you know, the difficulties that men have in terms of fertility. So please stay with us.